Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how and why you should choose background versus foreground behavior for your media. Hi and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been confused about the different media behaviors, foreground versus background, if you've ever called them the background layer and foreground layer when there is only one layer, I know I have, then go ahead, like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. This is a question that people that are newer to ProPresenter ask all the time. They're like, well, why would I ever want to have a foreground video? Background seems to work perfectly fine. Well, there's a couple of questions that I ask myself when I'm deciding if that's what I'm going to do. And as I've been doing these in-person trainings in front of audiences of, you know, 100 of y'all at a time, just different thoughts have come up, and so I thought that I would share them. So let's head over to the computer and we will take a look. So we're in ProPresenter, and some of these are foregrounds and some are backgrounds, like the Church Tech U desktop right there. I still had my key on, so that is a foreground. But why is it a foreground? Here, let me switch to just a regular audience view. Why do I have that as a foreground and say this as a background? Well, the first thought that I have when I'm deciding is it going to be a foreground or a background is I think to myself, is it the case that the entire point of this piece of media is for you to concentrate on it? Could I substitute it with something kind of similar? So for a background, if I've got nature footage, there may be similar nature footage that I could substitute, and chances are no one's going to notice the difference. If it's what a mentor of mine calls holy goo, where it's just an abstract background, I could probably swap that out with a similar abstract background and no one would notice. You know, maybe the worship pastor would go, you know, that's a little different than the one I thought we were going to use. But as long as it's similar colors, similar speed, it really doesn't matter all that much. So going back to this, if I were to swap that out for, say, lighter blues, maybe some people would notice, but maybe not. So it really doesn't matter all that much the background that I've selected. By contrast, if the pastor says, hey, we need to play a clip of the Passion of the Christ, starting at this time and ending at this time, if I swap that out for the Nativity story, that's really going to matter. If I swap that out for a clip from Lethal Weapon, they're both Mel Gibson, right? No, that's probably not going to work. So the entire point of a video clip, or in the case of the image that I showed you earlier, the Church Tech U image here, that's actually a different one. It's this one. The entire point is that image. It's like a slide. So that should be a foreground. And the reason that I would have that, notice backgrounds are persistent, so I've got an alternate theme on this, but you can see how as I'm switching between slides, it's persistent. Whereas if I drag up this foreground here and I click on it, that replaces this background because there is only one media layer. So this replaces this, and this replaces this. But when I click on this one, notice it's got this icon here, which is the drawing on top of the box. And this is exactly the opposite. It's a little box on top of a drawing. So in this case, the slide is the little box on the top and the drawing is the media behind it. And in this case, the drawing is the media right here with other layers that are behind it. So notice that when I click on this slide, the media goes away completely because I have replaced this with this and I haven't added new media in. So that's the next thought that I have is, okay, when I click on the next slide, what do I want to happen? Do I want it to be persistent? Background. See? Background. Or do I want it to go away immediately when I click on another slide? Foreground. That's what that will do. In general, backgrounds will tend to be looping if they're videos, and foregrounds will tend to be, will just stop. You don't want to watch the Passion of the Christ clip like multiple times generally. You can, but generally you don't want to do that. You just want to watch it through once and then the pastor completes the message. So that's what the difference between those two is. Another little piece of the puzzle is, let's see here, I think I've got a... Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. A loop, yeah, I do here. So, first off, I'm going to change this back to the presentation because I'm using the announcement layer for that guy. So, these are both on the slides layer, and right here, I have this slideshow timer set to 15 seconds. So we'll notice that right here it's going to advance on. With this one, it's set to 5 seconds. Well, if this was a video, so let's see here. I'm going to right-click and select foreground here for this video right here. I'm going to put it here. And as I start it playing, when it gets to the end with it as the foreground behavior, it stays until that 15 seconds is up, and then it will advance back here. And there it went. So, to get past that with a foreground piece of media, what I would do is I would add a go to next timer. So I right clicked on that, select go to next timer, and set that for however long after the media is done. So normally I do zero. You might do one, but in general, you're probably not going to do much longer than that. So once I do that, that will override this 15-second slideshow timer. And so when I do this and go to 5 seconds before the end using this feature right here, then go to the end and it immediately goes there. Now, watch what happens if I right-click, select the background behavior, exact same piece of media. It just has the different behavior, and I'm going to drag it right up here, and I'm going to add the exact same go to next timer, which was zero. And so when I do that, play this one, and it plays all the way through, go to the end. And then once it's done, it jumps to the next one, and then immediately it jumps to the one after that. Even though these are the exact same pieces of media, they are acting differently. So this is saying when you get to this slide, immediately after 0 seconds, jump to the next slide. In this case, the one at the beginning. This one, on the other hand, is saying after this is done, since it's the entire point of this slide, after it's done, advance it to the next one. And that's an important thing to know, because occasionally someone will be playing a video and they will not have thought whether it was in a foreground or a background, and they will set it either for the entire duration of this, so this is a 30 second video, so they'll set the go to next timer to 30 seconds, but if it was a foreground, it would finish, and then 30 seconds later, go to the next slide. As a background, it will play through the entire 30 seconds. So that's okay, but really, if the entire point is the slide, why do you want it to be like that? Another problem that you might run into is if you have a background in your slide loop, and you go ahead and you go to another slide, the background is persistent. So to get around that, you would have to add a clear action. Not necessary whatsoever, because if it was a foreground like it should have been, it would have cleared itself. So all those things are questions that you need to ask yourself when you are, here, let me select something else. There are questions that you need to ask yourself when you are deciding, hey, should this be a foreground? Should it be a background? What should I be thinking when I make that determination? If you like this content, you'll probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.